Hey, what's going on tonight, YouTube? It's me, DB, back with you for another round of NBA action, featuring the Bulldozer, DB, and the Miami Heat tonight facing off against my hometown team, the Boston Celtics, as you can see, led by Rajon Rondo. And I think that Rondo might be wanting out of Boston there pretty soon. And that's for the real game, of course. And also, guys, just to let you know while we're still loading the game here, unfortunately, I won't be able to do any video shooting next weekend. This weekend schedule is still all good. I'm still going to do my opening for you guys tomorrow, and also Mario Kart on Sunday. But next weekend, I'm going to be down at my grandma's, so I won't be able to do any video uploading then. But the following weekend, though, we should be back to our regular schedule. So just to let you guys know. So now, here we go. On to Kevin Harlan. Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Oh yeah, let's get it, y'all.
Showtime. Time to go out there and win, fellas.
That is the way you get your team fired up. I'd say they're anxious to get this one started. It's game time here in Miami as the crowds at the American Airlines Arena look to cheer on the hometown Heat. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. Hey guys, what are we going to be looking for in this one from Bradley?
And one thing he does as well as anybody, Kevin, is track the ball with his hands. Quick, strong, active. So when you go up for a shot, he's always going to be looking to strip it on the way up.
And also, if you watch him on the defensive end, you can see how tough it is to screen him off a play. I mean, he goes through it, around it, or under. He finds a way to shake off screens.
Looking at Boston, they want to turn it around after the loss to Orlando in Florida.
Well, loss or no loss, that was a fantastic game, Clark. They could be proud of the way they battled it, too.
I suppose, but Steve, it still was a really heartbreaking loss. I mean, you hate to lose in overtime. No matter how hard you played, it still leaves you very empty and disappointed when you come up short.
Here's Bass. Ray Allen grabs the board. Celtics on D. The Heat beat them last time when these two teams met down in South Florida.
Yeah, they really took it on the chin that last time out, and the difference was the turnover differential. When you look at the stat sheet, they were so careless with the ball, and those mistakes were just too much to overcome.
The Bulldozer passes to Bosh, and that one's good. Bosh has got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for Miami. Rondo, 8 points his last outing, and now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, thank you. I caught up with Eric Spoelstra. His team won the first meeting, and he felt it was simply because of the defensive intensity they brought to that game. He went on to say, we'll have to be even more active on that end. Now that they know what they're up against to score on us, we can't blink once on defense in this game and expect to win. Let's see if they can make it 2 wins on the year, guys.
Thanks, Doris. And as Doris provided the details, guys, the way they plan to attack defensively will be key early on, won't it?
Yeah, and early is the key word there, Kevin. If they can string together some stops right away, I think it'll really set the tone.
Which is just what they're going to be after, guys. They'd love to turn this into a defensive battle.
What about, Clark, what Steve just talked about? How was it possible for them to turn the ball over so much in that game?
Well, I mean, the defense was outstanding. Now, you got to give some credit where credit is due. But they also were a little sloppy at times with the ball.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. A free throw drops for Rondo.
You know, when something works for you, you stay with it. The Heat saw after the 2012 finals that small ball was very effective for them. You can see why they chose to do that, given how hard it is to find a power forward that can match up with LeBron. Makes good sense.
Wade drives in. Passes it to the Bulldozer. 6 on the shot clock. Puts it up from 17. And now it's Wallace running. He can go all the way.
Yeah, nice fast break from start to finish, guys.
Especially on the back end. I mean, he polished it off perfect.
The Bulldozer passes to Allen. Here's the Bulldozer. Tries it from 19, and he hits the jump shot. The Bulldozer's got his first basket of the night. And mismatches really are what make an NBA offense go at times. Not only can Miami overpower you, Steve, you know, with their sheer talent at times, but if you're trying to guard a perimeter player with a big, you're going to be in trouble.
Well, some people still see small ball as a gimmick, but, you know, for Miami, it's different because you've got LeBron James playing the power forward. So it's not really small ball. He can rebound, he can defend, he can do everything. And so the Heat become a nightmare to guard at the other end, and you can rarely take advantage of them offensively. You just assume he's going to knock those down when he's as open as he was there.
Rondo kicks to Bradley. Bass with a screen for Bradley. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. Bradley's got six.
Well, the pick worked really well there. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Wade against Bradley. Wade passes to the Bulldog. Puts it up from 15. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. Rondo off the pick from Humphreys. Outside Rondo. Now the dish to Bradley. Kept alive. Here's Humphreys. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. And let's take a moment, guys, to get your take on the scoring so far for Boston.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
And they're sharing the ball, too, which I love. They're piling up the assists and seeing great offensive movement.
You know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
Yeah, me too, Clark. I think anytime you have success pounding the ball inside, you got to continue to go to the well.
Now here's Rondo. Right now averaging 11 points a game. Leads him in there. Pass is shot. Good. Pass has got his second bucket of the night.
You know, one area that Rajon Rondo has struggled during his career is his free throw shooting. Just a little over 60% for his career. And that's not the type of percentage you're used to seeing from the point guard position.
You know, they'll want to generate more of those shots in tight, guys.
The Celtics with the lead. Passes to Bradley. Wallace outside. He feeds it to Humphreys. Nice ball movement by Boston. Rondo drives in. Clock at 4. Wallace kicks to Bradley. Drains it from beyond the arc. Bradley's got 9 points. And Stevie touched on Rondo's free throw percentage because of his slasher style of play. Clark getting inside. He does get to the line quite a bit.
And that's why getting that percentage up, Kevin, would definitely make a difference for him. You know, you don't think about it, but a guy raises his free throw percentage 5, 6, 7 percentage points over the course of a season. That's a point or two a game that could make a huge difference.
Bradley dishes to Wallace. No good. Well, he'd go the other way with it. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
And, Kevin, when you don't take advantage of your trips to the free throw line, which they definitely did not, it's tough to recover from.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, they left a lot of cheese and lettuce at that foul line, Clark.
Not to mention some ham and turkey, Clark.
Celtics leading by 5. Rondo with it, now guarded by the Bulldozer. Wallace misses.
Well, he's wide open there, but really struggles from that range. Maybe there's a reason he's open.
Bosh passes to the Bulldozer. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that.
Rondo kicks to Wallace. Rebounded by Battier. The Heat have gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. Pass to Allen. Here's the Bulldozer. He dishes at the box. Allen outside. Pass to Wade. From down in the low post, it goes. Wade's got 5 points so far.
Very well done. He is a confident, dynamic scorer.
And let's take a second to view a list of shooting guards who have been very dependable offensively this season. These two guards are the most accurate in the league. The Bulldozer. 11 points for him in that last game against the Hawks in Atlanta. Bosh dishes to Allen. The pass to the Bulldozer. Misses off the left iron.
Rebounds are split just about down the middle in this game, Clark.
I'd venture to guess whichever team is able to maintain that energy level on the glass will have the upper hand the rest of the way.
D-Wade the two with Ray Allen at the three. Shane Battier is out there with Kris Bosh, and it's the Bulldozer in at the point guard. It's the group on the floor for Miami. Just two to shoot. Wallace, good. Miami with the ball, trailing by two. They'll face the Lakers after this one. That'll be at home. And that's game two of this string of four games played at home.
I'm really looking forward to see how the Lakers fare in that one.
Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris?
He ended with 11 points, but also put up four boards. The iron was quite unkind to him as shot after shot ricocheted off the rim. He'll be looking to have a much better timeout this contest, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. And just not the game he hoped to have, guys.
It sure wasn't. And you know, to be a winner in basketball or the game of life, it takes experiences like that to cause you to use it as fuel to bring it that much harder the next time. Sometimes you grow through that adversity and disappointment. We'll see what he does here.
Well said.
Yeah, and the key is, I think, you have to have the right approach and the right attitude. You have to use the experience, but you have to let go of the emotion. And as long as he's motivated and excited to be out here, he can figure out what to do next and kind of take that next step forward.
Well, he's making a switch here. Odin's checked in. Humphreys, the pass to Rondo. Wallace, off target from outside. 56 seconds left in the first half. Feeds it to Odin. Passes it to the Bulldozer. Dishes it to Wade. From 14. The rebound by Humphreys. Humphreys has got his fifth rebound in this one. And it's sent back by Battier. Pass to the Bulldozer. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. And he's got his first free throw of the game.
Well, not the best statistic for him. I mean, his performance at the line, of course, very low numbers.
Guys, I think free throw shooting, and Steve, you can speak to this, is all about rhythm and confidence, and he hasn't been able to establish any rhythm there this season.
And the Celtics making a change here. Olynyk checked in. Wallace. Rebounded by Battier. Battier's got his third rebound tonight.
He continues to struggle from the field. But luckily for him and his teammates have been able to pick him up and get the job done.
Here's Wade. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play. The Celtics making a switch here. The Heat have attempted 11 free throws today and converted 8 of them. Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Celtics out in front, up by one.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Welcome, everyone. Let's see if we can spice up your Tuesday.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And a bird's-eye view of the American Airlines Arena, nestled on the waters of Biscayne Bay, as we return to South Florida.
What a stellar outing in this one for Crawford. 13 points, and he's managed to get 4 of his points by way of the free throw line.
And that may not be the first thing people notice about his performance, but those are important points nonetheless.
Miami trailing.
You know, if you just look at the numbers without knowing who Dwayne Wade was, you'd think he was probably 6'7 or 6'8. But the way he blocks shots and rebounds, even at 6'4, he just plays much bigger than he really is.
On the floor for Boston. Speedy backcourt of Rondo and Bradley. Ball is out there with Humphreys. And it's Bass in at the five, roaming the paint. And you go back, Clark, to that big man game for Wade, averaging about a block shot a game for his career.
Well, you think about it. He's 6'5", but he actually has a 6'11 wingspan. And you're not going to find a stronger guy at the shooting guard position. He's over 220 pounds, and there's nothing extra there, so he brings a lot to the table.
Wade, double team, and it's out of bounds to the Heat as Miami retains possession.
Here's where Boston sits right now, Kevin, in the current league ranking. Ninth in steals, 10th in rebounding, and they're in the top half of the league in free throw shooting as well. Pretty good, but they could certainly stand some improvement there.
What they try to do, Clark, is pressure the ball. I mean, you talked about the steals per game, and that's the key number of all those stats. They pressure the ball. They really create havoc for the offense. And when they take you out of the flow of your offense, it really makes the ball stop, and the game becomes very difficult for the offensive team.
And the Eastern Conference has been fun to watch. A lot of focus, as always, this year. And as we hit the midseason surge, let's check out the standings and how they're shaping up. Taking a look at Miami. Here in the middle of the regular season, they've been able to get the fourth best record in the conference. And of course, Boston, sitting there four spots below.
Well, right now for the Celtics, their season hasn't been great and it hasn't been terrible. It's been fairly pedestrian. A few times it's looked like they're about to turn the corner, but they just haven't been able to sustain that winning momentum.
And I'm not quite sure why that is, because I think they've got the talent to be among the league leaders. But it looks to me like it's not going to happen for them this year. See the way he times his passes so well? That's a great assist.
Rondo kicks to Bradley. The feed to Humphreys. And it's out of bounds. The Heat will take it the other way. And let's take a moment to show you the NBA's best rebounding teams over the last 10 games. Fifth on the list, the Celtics.
Kevin, that's been a nice run lately. They're making a strong effort on the board, and it's working and paying dividends for them.
It's tipped. It's stolen by Bradley. Kicks to Rondo. Bradley with the ball, and Bosh picks him up defensively. Rondo dishes to Wallace. Shot clock at 6. Some solid defense from the Bulldozer.
Pretty good defense there. I mean, that's a shot that he can make, but they really challenged him.
It's back to Battier. The Bulldozer. He kicks it to Allen. There's the dish to Bosh. It's stolen by Bass. And here's Bradley. 9 points in the game so far. He feeds it to Rondo. To the inside. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Bass has got his third basket of the night.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Well, that's important, because this game, I think, is going to be decided by who controls the paint in crunch time.
Outside Bosh, and the pass to the Bulldozer. No good on the triple. Celtics leading by 5. Bradley passes to Rondo. Pass with a screen for Rondo. Can't get it to go. Nice D from the Bulldozer. For Miami, they've gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Bosh, a screen on Rondo. It's Battier on the wing. There's the triple. But they'll get another chance. Humphreys with the steal. Rondo kicks to Wallace. And it's out of bounds. The Heat will take it the other way. And a moment to check out Miami and who they've got coming up. They'll face the Lakers after this one. That'll be at home. That'll be the second of 4 games at home for them.
And I'll be anxious to see what ends up happening with that Spurs game. Should be a good one.
The Heat trailed by 5. The Bulldozer passes to Batty. It's stolen by Bradley. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Pass to Rondo. Gets it to go. Rondo's got 9 points.
Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Well, their energy is lacking. They've got to start playing harder and battle down in the paint.
Allen kicks to Wade. Fades back. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim.
He's got 13.
I don't know of too many other players, Kevin, who have his level of concentration offensively. He just seems to have that singular focus you need as a shooter. That, you know, even if a defender's all over you.
Boston's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4-for-9. Crawford dishes to Bogans. A finger roll finish at the bucket. Bogans got his first bucket in this one.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
You know, Jordan Crawford was dealt from the Wizards to the Boston Celtics last season, guys, and that very well could be a good situation for him. He's a talented player who I think just needs a little more discipline defensively, and with his shot selection, he'll be fine.
Haslam can't get it to go. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Here's Brooks. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. And it's a 5-point Celtic lead.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Clark, you mentioned Jordan Crawford has been a gunner thus far in his career. And for his career, just to point out the numbers, about 40% from the field, and Steve, from beyond the three-point line, about 30%.
Well, the next shot he passes up will be the first one. but I enjoy watching him play. I mean, the guy has unlimited confidence. He's got great range on his shot. You know, when he gets it rolling, he can really catch fire.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Bass comes in for Olynyk, and it's Wallace in for Marshawn Brooks. And again, it's the Heat missing.
Boy, I tell you what, the complexion of this game would be completely different if he shot the ball anything like he's capable of. You're hot, and that's certainly been the case for Brad. 9 points, and the steals are starting to pile up for him also.
They sure have, and clearly he's gotten in their heads because of it, Clark. The guys are looking over their shoulder now, always worrying about where he is.
Kris Bosh has checked in for Udonis Haslam. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. Rajon Rondo has checked in for Jordan Crawford. On defense, Boston, 6-point lead. Wallace against Wade, 6 to shoot. Banked in off the glass. Wade's got 17.
What an excellent performance from the field for him.
5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Rondo kicks to Wallace. That's tipped. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. Wade with the ball. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark Power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Bradley drives in to the middle. Pass. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Pretty bad defense letting the offense get right to the rim, but smart play to foul once he was there.
But you know what's going to happen. They sent a message right there. Nothing easy inside. He's a dead eye at the line, fellas. Just call him automatic. He doesn't miss many of those.
And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. Celtics lead.
This Thursday night, January 23rd, Kobe Bryant and the Los Angeles Lakers.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Celtics.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
And the other thing they're doing is they're forcing turnovers and then converting those miscues into points at the other end.
Heck, he's in at the point. D-Wade, the two, with Ray Allen at the three. Shane Battier is out there with Kris Bosh. That's the group on the floor for Miami. Ball is off the pick from Bass. Just 5 on the clock. Humphreys, the pass to Bass. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Bass has got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Celtics. Here's the Bulldozer. And it's Wade penetrating. He's covered by Rondo. From 18 feet away, Wade misses. Deflects the pass. Here's Peck. The shot will not go. And the Celtics going the other way now. with a screen for Wallace. The open shot by Rondo, and too long on the shot. The Heat trail by six. Allen passes to the Bulldozer. He dishes it to Battier. He passes to the Bulldozer. Outside Bosh. Good ball movement here by Miami. No good from the Bulldozer.
Misfires again, and the ball just refuses to cooperate with him. It's a tough day so far.
Wallace dishes to Rondo. Back to Wallace. Outside Brent. All sorts of time. Gets it to go. And the Celtics lead by eight. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Well, guys, I was able to listen in on what Eric Spoelstra was going over with his team in that last huddle. He told his players, turnovers are killing us right now. We can't keep trying to make the home run play. Settle down, run the offense, and make the simple pass. Kevin, sounds easy enough.
Back to Bosh. Pass on him. The jump hook, and that one's good. 12 points for Kris.
I'll tell you what, he's enjoyed a very good day shooting the ball so far. He can bring him right back into this.
Rondo with it. Outside Brent. Feeds it to Wallace. A baseline J, and it's rejected. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Wade drives in. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Nice numbers from D-Wade. He's got 19 points and the one steal. That kind of mix of assists and rebounds is what wins you basketball games.
Well, you've got to love having a guy who can do both those things well.
Both free throws good from Wade. And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Outside Rondo. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful.
He's been much more effective in the second half than he was in the first.
The Heat trailed by six. It's back to Battier. Here's Peck. Good on the triple. Now Rondo. Passes to Brent. Goes back up. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Well, because of his passing ability, Kevin, I mean, if you're going to play with him, your only job is to get open on the floor because he will get you the ball, and he'll give it to you in rhythm so that you can get a good shot off.
And what a maestro he is as well. I can't tell you how many times I've seen him throw what looks like a blind pass, and I wonder where it's going, and suddenly it's right on target in the hands of his teammates for a basket.
And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. And boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is. And so they will award the basket there.
Almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
Celtics making a switch here. Crawford's checked in. The Celtics have gone 3 of 8 here in the fourth quarter. Rondo off the pick from Bass. Blocked.
You know, they haven't been able to open up a big lead, but the rebounds are starting to add up for them. They may be able to pull away a little bit.
Yeah, they've been doing the dirty work inside, Steve, playing a very tough brand of basketball.
The Celtics with the lead. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Washington. They'll face the Wizards. That'll be the third game of this three-game road trip. Miami grabs the miss. Allen's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Bosh, a screen on run. Allen. Can't tie it up as that one's no good.
Yeah, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway. Good ball movement. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Oh, yo, who got red? Get red. dishes it to Wade. The Bulldozer. Lays out. It's stolen by Rondo. And here we go. Fast break. Crawford's got it. Makes the lead pass. Humphreys, no good.
Yeah, trying to put a little mustard on the hot dog there. That was just convert the shot. Come on.
Pulls up. Miami, no good on that time either.
It's in his head now, guys. I mean, he just can't get anything to go, and it's affecting his team big time.
Crawford kicks to Humphreys. And it's good off the glass. And the Celtics lead by six.
Got a good clear look right over the top of his defender because of that height advantage.
The drive by Wade, 18 feet out. Miami no good on that time either. The Celtics shooting in the fourth quarter has looked shabby, 38%. Rondo passes to Crawford. Pass to Bass. The feed to Rondo, five to shoot. Smooth as silk on the finger roll.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
The Heat trail by eight. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Here's Peck. And again, it's the Heat missing.
I think the game plan needs to change here, guys, if they're going to get out of the hole, because he is not helping their offense.
Crawford dishes to Rondo. Now Wallace inside. And the shot is good. And now a 10-point Celtic lead.
And now we can see them really working it inside.
Taking advantage of the defense, really pounding it down low.
To stop the run. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Celtics have gone 7 of 15 from a 4 here in the fourth. Right around 46-47%. Rondo kicks to Humphreys. Division out to Bass. Battier on him. Got a piece of it. Battier with the steal. Allen drives in. Rondo with the steal. And pushing it up, here's Boston. The finger roll finish at the bucket. And the Celtics lead by 12.
His shots are dropping right now. This quarter has been very kind to him.
And a new group in for the Celtics. Olenek is checked in for Bass. Green comes in for Kris Humphreys. Jeff Green is checked in for Gerald Wallace. And it's Marshawn Brooks in for Rajon Rondo. Kicks it to Jones from outside the arc. And that one's good.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the three-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
Clark, they're in good position here to ride it out.
Yeah, they certainly are. I mean, if they just play smart right here, Kevin, this game's pretty much over.
Olenek the pass to Crawford. Lock at six. And Anthony sends it back. Here's Cole. Brooks covering. And count it. The shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
And that's a difficult shot in the face of a defender that towers over.
Well, you know, he almost seems to enjoy those mismatches, Steve. It gives him a chance to show what a strong finisher he is.
Now here's Crawford. And so it's the Boston Celtics with the W. They came, they saw, they conquered.
Hey, Kevin, to me, any...
All right, folks, that was a tough one. See, I did not see well that game at all.
Yeah. It's been a ride.
We've certainly seen bigger games from you out there. In fact, I'd even say you looked a little complacent at times tonight. Any response?
Oh, come on, man. Easy now. I don't think I was complacent at all, and that goes for my teammates, too. Sure, I didn't have my best game, and we weren't able to pull out the W, but that's no reason to start bringing up words like complacent. That's a pretty big thing to be throwing out there, and something I don't think you'd be saying if you followed this team more closely this year. Come on.
Hey guys, that's gonna do it for me tonight. I hope you all enjoyed this game, even though we lost. Just let me know in the comments below, where do you think I should get traded? Or do you guys think I should stay with Miami and help to fix this, help right this ship, or this boat? As they say, look at the norm, mate. Fate was on me. I can feel the energy in the air. If I like, I'm all right. So, once again, let me know in the comments below. I'm BB, and I'm done. See you later. Again, and it's let me know in the comments. So, if you guys think I should get traded to somewhere else, or do you think I should stay with the Miami Heat? All right, so I'm done. See ya.